This was a reflection of who Jill Biden really is, that teacher, that warmth, that personal sort of message to that this is the nice guy, my husband, Joe Biden.
You know, one of the things in this speech, as we look at the text, I love that line, how do you make a broken family whole the same way you make a nation whole? This empathy idea that they continue to hit on Michelle Obama last night and Dr. Jill Biden tonight. The implication being Joe Biden has put the country first, even in moments of pain.
Strikes me, Jamal, as Margaret is talking, that she essentially vouched for him as the healer in chief.
Yeah, I want to go back to Michelle Obama for just a second. You know, she's known for when they go low.
I thought you might. Yes.
Well, I know. I can't stop thinking about it, to be honest with you. Her message was heard loud and clear. You know Barack Obama very well, too. What do you expect from him tonight? And I'm wondering if he's feeling pressure because Michelle Obama seemed to have knocked it out of the park.
And this was, it was a partisan speech on one level, but it was beyond that from President Obama, a speech that many people, while Senator Harris's speech was historic in and of itself and had its own power, they're talking about the 22nd Amendment that bans a president from going beyond two terms. Democrats are looking at that Obama speech tonight and saying maybe one day he could come back, maybe that 22nd Amendment could be repealed.
I have to think, for the rest of us, it was a stunning speech. I think that she really had more self-confidence and more impact than a lot of vice presidential acceptance speeches, but it's particularly for black women and girls.
Fireside chat, and then took on the tone at the end of the fervency of almost a preacher at the pulpit. It was a deeply optimistic speech, hopeful. It was intimate. And it was very suited to a virtual convention.
It really seemed like he was trying to buck up a nation that has been through a lot.
I have to say, having watched Joe Biden since the 70s when he first ran for the Senate, I have never seen him deliver a better speech. He talks, as you say, so optimistically, saying, are we the generation that can wipe the stain of racism from our national character? I think we can. It was all hopeful. It was not partisan at all, in fact. He was talking about bridging the divide.
Democrats have laid down a marker, and Joe Biden closed it very well. This is a unified Democratic Party. This was a really well-run convention. They stretched their tent out really well without ripping any holes in the middle. I think this is a highly successful convention, and it lays down a marker for Donald Trump next week. I don't know if they can match it.
But think of it, a man who's waited about 50 years to get nominated by his party to be president gets to do it tonight unexpectedly in his own hometown. Talk about a dream come true. Oh, an incredible set of remarks, and I think to John's point earlier, more of a presidential style address. He's not someone who is known to give soaring speeches, but tonight certainly delivered it.
It was a great speech. I think it was better than what many of us expected because he was able to combine both the show that empathy, show that hope, give people that hope. So I think it was important for him tonight to make people feel that hope.
Thank you for just continuing to do your job and showing up and speaking to the public because we need you. I think Michelle Obama's speech was pretty flawless.
Yeah. I mean, she's Michelle Obama and you're not. Like, there's nobody like her in the world. For him to come out with a warning, to say, this is really bad. We're really at risk. Our country might not be a democracy anymore, depending on what happens in the next election, because the people in power now are happy to do away with democracy as our form of government. I just feel like, separate and apart from how well they're running the convention, those two speeches from Michelle and Barack Obama are going to stick with me, and I think stick with a lot of people for a long time.
And they've got to make the case for Joe Biden, and I don't think they're doing anything differently in this convention that they've been trying basically since 2016.
Really, right. Were you watching the convention last night? It felt very different.
Yeah, I would. I know you were.
I'm being facetious.
The attacks on a candidate or an office holder are most acutely felt by the people who love them most. And Donald Trump got impeached over his effort to take your husband and smear your family and weaken your husband politically.
I have to think about, I mean, what kind of a person would attack a man's only living son? Right? I mean, the attacks on Hunter Biden for getting a job or getting on a board, right?
That sound that you hear all across the country is the sound of Democrats exhaling. That's what that is. People would have accepted anything. We just wanted Joe to get out there, So, you know, sometimes when he gets out there, you're afraid he's going to make a mistake. He's going to have a gaffe. The set expectations are just so low. And we were prepared for it to be a terrible speech. As long as he didn't embarrass himself, we were going to come out here and praise it. You don't have to make nothing up tonight.